People are very much expertised in the programming language. That doesn't mean that you attend the classes late. Okay. Hope you don't attend the classes late there. I'll show you the log. Just check whether it is as per your knowledge. Anyways, so good morning, students. So today, as a part of module one, which is Python basics, so the agenda for today's class here is about the for loop and about the range function and some of the programs dealing with the same. Okay, can anybody just recall what did we do in the last class, students? What was the
we discussed while loop.
We discussed about the while loop. Okay, can anybody just tell me, if I ask you what is a while loop, how would you tell? I'll tell you, just tell me what is a while loop. What would you tell? What are the points would you like to cover? Forget about the sentences. What points would you like to cover? It's a what kind of a control flow statement, students? What type of a control flow statement it is?
Looping.
Looping or an iterative statement. Okay, and then how would you dissipate next? What does it do? What is the task of the while loop? Come on.
It executes the loop and constructs until it unless the condition is true.
Okay, so the while loop will repeat certain set of statements, which I call it as clause. Okay, till the condition becomes false. That means to say, if the condition is evaluated to true, it keeps executing the statements. Once the condition is evaluated as false, it will skip the statements. Sure? Am I correct for that? Yes. Students?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Can anybody give me the syntax of while loop? See, if you don't answer, I'll have to call your names. If I call your names, I think I can know who is there, who is not there then. Okay. What is the syntax of while loop?
While, condition,
then. Condition, then?
Clause.
Okay. Directly you'll write while, condition, and then the clause.
There is a
So syntax has a keyword while followed with the condition. See, you should tell what is the condition. I hope I have told you that. See here, where is that? You should tell in this way. While is having the keyword followed with the condition, which is an expression that evaluates to true and false. Then the colon. Then on the next line, an indented block of code, which we call it as the while clause. See, you should give this description, students, if they ask you to give the syntax. See, this will carry one mark. Try to understand. Then give the syntax, which goes like this. And then the flowchart. So if it is for 5 marks, you will have 1 mark for explaining what is a while, then 1 mark for telling what is the syntax containing, then writing the syntax, which is for 3 marks, then flowchart, 4 marks, and then a small example program for 1 mark again, or 1 or 2 marks, depends on the examiner. Are you understanding? So do not neglect. Fine? Is that clear, students? We saw some of the programs there also in last class. But today we will see about for loop, its syntax and other things. And the range function, which is very important, which is a part of your for loop, which is used in your data structures also, okay, and some of the programs. Okay, now if I ask you what is a for loop, so what is a for loop again? What is a for loop, students? Speak out. What kind of a control flow statement it is? What type of a control flow statement it is, students? Nobody is there?
looping or iterative,
looping or an iterative statement. Okay, so we all know that the while loop here keeps looping until the while condition, I mean the condition is true. So it keeps repeating till the condition is true. But what if programmer wants to execute a block of code, okay, only a certain number of times? I don't want some condition to be there. I just want a block of code to be executed certain number of times. I want some block of code to be executed for 5 times or 10 times or 100 times. Okay, so this can be achieved. This motto of executing a block of code for certain number of times can be achieved by using a for loop statement along with another function called as a range function. Okay, so if at all I have to write for followed with an range function, the syntax or the way of writing goes like this. So you can see, first you have to write for keyword followed with a I. What is I to me here? What is I to me? It's a normal variable followed with a keyword, so called as an in, then followed with a range function. So you still don't know what is range function, but I'll just tell you. Just right now look into the syntax. So for, in, both are keywords. I is in a variable followed with a range function which takes an integer argument. So it takes 3 arguments. Right now just assume now it is taking an integer argument with a colon. Yes, followed with the colon, in the next line you will write the indented block of code which is your for clause. Yes, so for is a keyword followed with any variable name. So I have given I, you can give anything, followed with in keyword, and then followed with a call to the range function, wherein the range function, as I said, it can take up 3 integers passing to that as an argument, right? 3 integers, fine, followed with the colon. Then on the next line we will write the indented block of the code which we call it as a for clause. Is that clear? Yes, students. So for loop, as I said, it is an iteration statement, and the other name that we also give for for loop here is, it is also known as definite loop. Definite loop. So in your exams, if they ask you explain definite loop syntax, so you should not get panic there. Definite loop is nothing but your for loop. Why it is called as a definite loop? Because looking at your for loop, I can easily tell how many times the for loop gets executed. That's the reason we call it as a definite loop. Whereas in while loop, it depends on the condition. See, it may execute once, it may execute 100 times based on the condition, and while loop is called as indefinite loop. Understanding? Yes. So the for loop has the capacity to iterate over a set of numbers. I can iterate. Iterate in sense, I can repeat the block of code over a set of numbers or a set of words or a lines in a file, or using iterate over the data structure such as list, tuple, dictionaries, sets. So the for loop can be used in various scenarios. Okay, and the syntax for it goes again like this. You can see for keyword followed with a variable name, then next is in keyword, and then after in you can give anything. Yeah, it can be a list of numbers, it can be list of names or a sequence of numbers. Okay, or you can give call to the range function, or you can give a string, or you can give a list, dictionary, tuple, anything you can give here, wherein for will iterate over this inputs. Are you understanding? will iterate over this inputs. Yes, so how does it iterate? Very simple, the variable will iterate over the elements present in this. It will traverse. So for every element present in the list, the block of the code will be executed. Okay, try to understand. So below that we have block of the code there. So what does it do is very simple here. The for loop will start traversing the list of numbers or the string or the sequence one by one, from which element to which element, in what sequence it will traverse or it will iterate. Students, yesterday I told you that from which element to which element, yeah? If I give a list of numbers, the variable will traverse the list of numbers from which element to which element?
Left to right.
That is first to last, one by one. Very simple there. So given a list, it will traverse your list elements from beginning to the end, one by one. Okay, there is no skipping and all. Fine. So variable, what is now given to you, acts as a iterator variable, wherein it iterates over the list of numbers. Okay, so using this concept, you should use it in a right way. Okay, so the syntax, or sorry, the flowchart goes like this. You can just see here. So what is, how does the flowchart work is, for each item in sequence, correct? No, for every item in the sequence, as I said, the item will be now in the list or in the sequence or in the range or in the string literal. So for each item in the sequence, what will I do? I'll just check whether the last item has been reached. Okay, is the last item been reached for me? No. If no, check the execute the statements and then again go back. Again, take the next item in the sequence. If it is not reached the last element in the list, okay, then that means to say it has traversed all the elements in the list, right? So if it has reached all the elements, right? Yes, it has reached all the elements, come out of the for loop, exit from the for loop. Very simple. So variable is like a temporary iterator variable which iterates over the list of the numbers. Are you getting, students? Yes, from the beginning to the last, it will iterate over to it and execute the set of statements which is given to me under the block. Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So before we go for a small program, okay, so I will just first tell you about the range function. So what is a range function? It is a built-in function which is available in Python, wherein it is used when a user needs to perform an action for a specific number of times. So if I want to do something for a specific number of times, especially in your for loop, we make use of the range function, which is a built-in function. Okay? So what does the range function do? It is not something different. It is basically used to generate a sequence of numbers. It will generate what? A sequence of numbers. Suppose say it can generate from a number from 1 to 10, or it can generate a number from 5 to 20, or it can generate all odd numbers, or it can generate all even numbers within a range, or it can generate negative numbers. So it can generate a sequence of numbers. Okay? So it will generate the sequence of numbers within a given range provided by the user. Okay, so allows the user to generate. So it is user friendly. So user can generate any range or any sequence of numbers from one end to an other end. Okay, so depending on, as I said, range takes how many arguments? How many arguments range will take? Earlier I told you, how many arguments range function takes? Students?
Three.
So range take three arguments. It can take three arguments wherein the user can now decide based on the three arguments that has been provided, how many arguments he should give. Is it one or is it two? Or is it three? So he cannot give zero. Either he can give one or two or three. He can give any of these arguments, not zero. Yes, but when I give one, how will the interpreter take? When I give two, how will the interpreter take? When I give three, how will the interpreter treat? So we'll see that, right? So by passing the arguments, so user can decide upon the series of numbers he can generate from where and from where it has to end. So the user can decide where that series of numbers will begin and end. So if I have to generate a numbers from 5 to 10, what is my beginning of that range? If I have to generate a number from 5, what is my end?
10.
And if I want only odd numbers, then what should I generate? After 5, what should I generate?
7.
So even that you can make with this range. And how big the difference will be between one number and the next? Can you see how big difference it will be between one number and the next here? Right? That also I can decide based on my range function arguments. Okay, so we'll see that. Anyways, so range basically takes three arguments. First argument is your start. So integer starting from which the sequence of integers is to be returned. Remember, the first argument what we now give is start, which indicates the beginning of my sequence of integers. And second argument is stop. Can you see here? Second argument is stop. It's again an integer before which the sequence of integers will be returned. So remember, whatever stop you give, the sequence of numbers will end at stop minus 1. Now, can anybody just tell me, if I want to generate numbers from 5 to 10, what is my starting value?
5.
What is my top value?
9. 11.
It will generate the numbers which ends at stop minus 1. So what is my stop value?
11.
Because I want to generate from 5 to 10 sequentially. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you should make sure that the stop value should be one larger than what you want to generate, because range function is designed in that way. It will generate sequence of numbers one less than stop. So the range of integers that you generate will end at stop minus 1. So you should take care. Okay. Next is, the next argument is step. So as you all know, step means, again, it's an integer value which determines the increment between each integer. Okay? Increment between each integer. Right? Suppose say I want to give sequence of numbers from 5 to 10. Okay. You all know, start is now what, ma? Start is what, students? Start is what? 5 to 10 if I have to generate. What is my start value?
5.
What is my end value? Stop value, sorry. 11. And I want to generate the numbers like this. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So what is my step value?
1.
It should be incremented. The difference between those two integers is now 1. Is it clear, students? Yes?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
So, now, as I said, we now take three arguments, but I told you earlier here, I can give one argument, I can give two arguments, I can give three arguments. I can give, no problem. But when I give one argument, what is that? When I give two arguments, what is it? Interpreted. Three, what? Let us see what it is. Okay? Suppose if I give one argument to my range function, so it will be treated as which argument?
Stop.
Stop. Remember, if I give one argument, it will not take a start. It is stop. Now you can ask me, ma'am, then what is the start value? Can anybody guess what is the start value in this case? Can anybody guess what is the start value in this case? What will the interpreter do in this case? What is the start value? By default, if you give one argument, it will be stop, right? So what is the start value? There should be some start value, right? So by default, it will take it as what, students?
Zero.
Zero. Stop, anyways, you have given. So zero, comma, stop. Then you have not given step also. Yes, by default, even the step value is what now, students? One. Understood? Are you getting?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So if you give one argument, it is considered as stop. By default, start is what? Speak out.
Zero.
Zero. And step is what?
One.
So the compiler, can you see this? If you write like that, compiler will generate this range function call. Sure? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Can anybody now guess, if I give range 5, what all numbers it will generate? Range 5.
0, 1, 2.
Yes, 0, 1, 2.
3, 4.
Because it will not generate 5, because top is itself 5, so 1 less than it, so 4. Yes, is that clear? Is that clear, students?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Next, I can give two arguments also. So if I give two arguments, first one is start, second one is stop. Okay, I did not give step. So what is the default value of step?
One.
By default, it will take one. So if you want to interpret this, so it will be default start is given. I'm not able to write here, but anyways, start, stop, and my default value is 1, step value. Okay. So for example, if I give range 5 comma 12, what it will generate?
5 to 11.
One increment only. Okay. Next, I can give three arguments. Start, stop, and step. I can give three arguments also. If I give step, see, one I need not have to mention. Other than one, if there is any step value, you mention it. Depends on the user. Is that clear, students? Is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Some examples I have just given here. Let's look at this. Range 6. So what does it generate, students?
0 to 5.
Look at here, I have given 6, one argument. So 6 is treated as which argument?
Stop.
So before to that, it has to stop. That is 5. And what is the start value here?
0.
Zero. Step value is also?
1.
What is the output that I get? 0, 2, 4, 5. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. The next example. Range 0, 6. So what is 0 treated as?
Starting value.
Starting value of this sequence of numbers. What is 6 treated as?
Stop.
Stop. And starting is given to you. Anyway, see, if at all 0 was your start, you need not mention. You could have mentioned only 6. But as an example, I've just taken. So it generates the numbers from where to where?
0 to 5.
Okay. Next.
0 to 5.
Yes. Next. 0, 10, 2. Okay. What is my 0?
Starting.
What is my 10?
Stop.
And what is the step value?
2.
So, I should step by 2. Increment my starting value by 2. So, what is the output that I get, students?
Even number, 0 to 8.
0, 0 plus 2, 2, 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 2, 8, 8 plus 2, 10. Will it display 10?
No, ma'am. No.
Why?
The stop value.
Stop value. So it will generate the sequence of numbers till where?
Till 8.
Till? 8. In general. Till?
9.
In general? Okay, 9. In general?
Stop minus 1.
So it will generate the numbers till stop minus 1. Very simple. The numbers that you generate should be less than stop. It cannot be equal to
stop.
Very good. Okay. So I just want to ask some question. You have learned some progressions in your mathematics.
Yes, ma'am.
What are the different types of progressions?
Arithmetic progression.
Arithmetic, geometric progression.
Okay. Okay. Now this range function generates what kind of progression? What kind of progression? Arithmetic or geometric? Geometric, sorry. Come on, student.
Arithmetic. Mark.
Arithmetic progression. So what is A value here?
Start value.
Start value. And what is your D value?
1.
It is stop value. I think you are getting what I'm trying to tell. Okay. I think you people would be knowing about the same. Is that clear, students? Is the range clarity? There's a clarity with the range function now?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Some points to remember about the range function. Very important. It can be asked as MCQs and all. Range function works only with integers. It will not work on what?
String values.
String or floating point. No, it works only on integers. Means to say, my arguments should be only integers. It cannot work on float numbers. Okay. All arguments must be integers. You cannot pass a string or a float number or any other type in as start, stop, and a step argument. Okay. So remember, range function generates only set of integers. Arguments also should be set of. See, when arguments are integers, numbers also will be integers. That's all. Very simple as it is. And one more thing that you should remember, the three arguments that you give can either be positive or negative. You should deal properly. So there is no restriction, right? It can be either be positive or negative, but you should write the arguments in the right way. That's all. Then remember, the next thing is the step value that you give should not be zero. You cannot give step value as zero. right? If at all, by mistake, if you give step, see, there is no point if the step value is zero. I cannot generate any numbers if the step value is zero. So if by chance, if you give zero, it gives an exception called as value error exception. Because in range step value, it is defined as it cannot be zero. So you have given a value which is not applicable. So it gives you a value error exception. Is that clear? And range function is a type in Python. As you have int, float, string, str, right? Range function is also one of the type in Python. Is it clear, students? Shall we go for the execution part of it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. Okay. I think I'll show one or two for range, then I'll come back to this. Can you all see, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am. Okay, so I first give you type. I told range is a type in Python. See, if I give type, type is an inbuilt function which tells you the type of the argument here. Okay, let us press enter and see what do I get. See, what is the answer that you get? Class range. Range method is a type. It is a type present in your Python called as a range. Are you understanding, students? Are you getting it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. Now, let us now deal with example. You can see here you get, you can either give one argument or two arguments, or optional is three arguments also. Okay. So what does it generate? Range 6. Students, numbers from where to where?
0 to 5.
Okay, but you will not get the answer. It will simply give me like this. Range 0 comma 6. So if you want it to work here, you will have to include inside this list function range comma 6. Because whatever the numbers it generates, it should be converted to a list. Okay, so that's the reason we have to embed this there. Now, what is the answer that you get? You can now see it is the list of the numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Why till 5? Because top value is now what? 6. Is that clear? Is it clear, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay,
yes, ma'am.
Next, list. But when you use in for loop, no, automatically interpreter will take care. But when you are using on command interpreter, you have to use it in this format. Okay. Can anybody guess the answer for this?
It prints from 2 to 8.
2 to 8. One after the other. Okay. Next. List. Range. I'll just give 2 comma 10, okay, comma 2. What does it display?
2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 10?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay, okay. So it is in step of 2. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 5. Next, list, range, 20 comma 10 comma minus 2. Can anybody guess the answer? What did I do? I can give negative arguments, right? I give right arguments or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Step value is now minus 2. Okay. Now what is the answer?
2018
downwards till where?
12.
Let us see. Yes, 2018, 16, 14 till 12. Okay, you can give anything as negative arguments there, not an issue. Range minus 5, comma. Minus 5, let's see, minus 10, comma 2. What do I get? Will it work? Empty. Oh. Plus range, I think the other way I should give. Minus 10, minus 5, comma 2. Okay. What do I get, ma'am? Answer?
Minus 10.
Minus 10.
Minus 10.
Minus 8.
Minus 8. Minus 6. Okay. So it is, the step value is 2. Positive. So minus 10 plus 2. Then minus 8. Minus 8 plus 2. It goes like that. See, here you could see I got list empty. Why? Because minus 5 plus 10 will give me what? Minus 5 plus 2 will give me what?
Minus 3.
Minus 3 is not in the range. No. So it will not display for me. Because my range is minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8, minus 9, minus 10. That's the reason the result came to be as empty for me. Okay, let us see this. Yes. So minus 10, minus 8, minus 6. Okay. Next one. List. Range, this is negative, right? Minus 10, comma, minus 15, comma, minus 2. What's the answer?
Minus 12 and minus 14.
Minus 10 is there?
Yes, ma'am.
Minus 10, minus 12 and minus 14. Very good. Next, last one. 10 comma 20 comma 0. What did I do?
Value error.
Value error. Why value error?
Increment is 0, ma'am.
Step value is 0. Yes. Can you see? Range argument 3 must not be 0. So I get a value error. Yes. Next. Last one. List range 2.2, I will give, comma 4.4, some value I'll give, or I forget about 0.2, I will give like this. Will it work?
No, ma'am.
Why?
Range works
on negative numbers. Argument should be, it works only on integers. Your argument should be integers only. Yes. See, it gives an error, type error, because it works only on integers. This is type error. Type is different. Here it was value. Why? Because value cannot be zero, right? So float object cannot be interpreted as an integer. You cannot take this as an integer. No, not possible. Is that clear, students? Is that clear? Okay. Now, programs on the for loop. Okay. Fine. First program which I would like to tell you is printing the values from 0 to 4 using for loop. Okay. So just I want the numbers to be printed from 0 to 4. So how do I do that? I use a for loop, then the variable name I, then the keyword in, then the range function, because if I have to just display the values from 0 to 4, range is sufficient for me. Yes? Can you guess if I have to generate the values from 0 to 4, what should be my range method? Call to my range method. Range?
5.
Range 5.
If two arguments means?
0, 5.
If three arguments means?
0, 5, 1.
It depends. So preferably, first one is 5. Range 5. So, when I give this, can you just see what I printed? So as I told you, I iterates over the sequence of numbers. So I will start iterating over the sequence of numbers. First, I will have 0, next 1, next 2, next 3, next 4. So the number of iterations performed here is now how much here? 5 times, right? So I can simply give print I sufficient. If I give print I, so I first iteration will contain what value, students? First iteration, it will contain what value? 0. Next iteration, what does it contain?
1.
Students, 1. Next it is 2. Next it is 3. Next it is 4. Okay, fine. Say, if you want, if I want you to show the okay, is it visible, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, program to print the numbers from 0 to 4. Okay, very simple. It is for I in what, ma? Range what?
5.
Colon. So print. So you might tell me, ma'am, how I will hold the value. That's how it works actually. So print I. I'll just give print I. That's it. Fine. So let us execute and see how exactly the interpreter will deal with that. See, for I in range 5. See, can you see the value of I, students, here? I is having
0.
Why? Because the range function would have generated the numbers as list 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I will is a variable that iterates over the list of numbers. In the first iteration, I will contain the value of first number in the sequence. The first number in the sequence is what, ma? First number in the sequence is what?
0.
Can you see that here? Okay. Next, prints I. So I is printed here. What is the value of I here? 0. Next, can anybody tell me for the next iteration, I contains what value? The next number in the sequence?
1.
So just look at this. You can just look at this. It changes automatically to 1. So print I. Yes, it prints 1. And in the next iteration, what is the next number I should now contain or traverse?
2.
You can just see here, it will be now I2. So remember, the variable which is used here in the for loop will iterate over the sequence of numbers from the beginning to the last, and it will hold the values. Okay. So similarly, it will print. Can you see the value which is printing here? Similarly, next, what is the value of I?
3.
Yes. So it prints 3. Next, what is the value of I?
4.
It will print 4. Again, you can see the control goes back here. But you can see now, I have traversed or iterated over all the numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Is there any element left out in the list of numbers or the sequence of numbers generated by range? Is there any?
No.
Therefore, the condition becomes what here? I mean, sorry. Therefore, what happens to the for loop? The for loop will be terminated, comes out of it. Right? So I have printed now 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Clear, students? Is it clear? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. One second. Now, just tell me, what does this print? Okay. What does this print? What does it print?
Five. Reverse order. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Will it print 0?
No, ma'am.
No. Sure. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. What is the value of I initially?
5.
I, 4. Next.
5.
2. Okay. Next one. Next. It is terminated. So it will not print 0. Is that clear? Is it clear, students?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, I told you with range function. Now, I told you even it can take string as a. Anybody tell me now, what does this looping does for me? Or this program does for me? Quickly.
It prints each word of hello.
It prints
each letter of the word each. Hello.
Using for loop, you can even traverse a string character by character. Okay. Can anybody tell me what does I contain initially?
H.
H. See here. Can you see that? Students? Can you see, ma?
Yes, ma'am.
H. Next, what does I contain? So it will print I. I will have now H. Okay, prints. Next, what does I contain?
E.
E.
L.
L. Next.
L.
Again L. Next.
O.
Okay, next. Next. After O.
It comes out of for loop.
It exits the for loop as I've done traversing all the characters in a string. Is that clear, students? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now. Some names we will give. Let us not mention the names. Okay. We'll give Ram. Then. Sham. Okay. Then B. Okay. What is this now? What is LS for me here?
List.
A list. Okay. So I'll just give like this. For I in LS. Print. Hello. I. Okay. Can anybody guess what is this program doing for me?
It prints hello Ram. Hello.
Sham.
Hello Sham.
Okay. Why in this case what is I iterating upon? It is iterating list. It is taking every element in the list one by one. Okay, I have a question. How many times this for loop executes in this case?
Three times.
It is a kind of a loop is for loop. There's a special name given, no? I said
oops. Definite.
Definite loop. Easily I definite see loop. Looking at this, easily I can tell yes. It is working three times because my list is of three elements. It will iterate three times. Now let us see whether it works as you said. Okay. LS is there. Can you see? This LS, it is a data type, right? You can see how it is created. Next. Yes. Okay. We'll see about this later. Let us not scratch our head for this. For I in LS. So what is I containing now? Initially.
Ram.
Ram. You can see here. Can you all see, students? Yes, sir. Yes. Okay. Print. Hello. Hi.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello. Hi. Okay. What does it print? Hello?
Hello, Ram.
Okay. Next. What does I contain? What does hello, I contain?
Sam.
Okay. Sam, here. You should observe this. See, I'm using this visualizer because I cannot do it on the board. So it's easy way for you to understand. Tracing portion especially. Okay. Hello, Sham. Okay. Next. What does I contain?
Beam.
Beam. Next. Hello, Beam. Then what does I contain? Nothing. Why? Because I have done with traversing all the elements. So what happens to my for loop? It exits. That's my answer. Did you all get?
Yes.
Okay. The same thing is here, which I have dissipated on the this activity. Fine. So a few programs which I want to deal with using for loop now. Okay. Write a short program that prints the numbers 1 to 10 using a for loop. Okay. Can anybody tell quickly?
For I in range 1 to 11.
Okay. Then print I. Similarly, you have to write an equivalent program that prints the number 1 to 10 using a while loop. Okay. Same program using a while loop also you should print. Fine. You can do it, not an issue. Next program is to find sum of n numbers where n is read from the user. Now, n is a value read from the user. Can anybody tell me that range function to find sum of n numbers? Range function only you tell me. Range
n plus 1.
Okay, range n plus 1. Fine. Or okay, default start value is 0, 0, 0, n plus 1. Fine. Or it can be range 1,
n plus 1.
N plus 1 based on the user. Okay. So next is, I think you can find the sum. Instead of printing, you should find the sum of n numbers. Hope you can do it. Hope you can do this.
Yes, ma'am.
Do it. You will do it, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Try doing it. We will discuss it anyways. To find factorial of a number, so it is a challenge for you to sit and code it. Okay, for factorial of number. Anyways, I'll discuss these two last two programs. Try to do these two programs. Even this you must do. First two programs you must do. Third and fourth, try doing it. If not, I will discuss it in the next class. The last program is to create the multiplication table of a number from 1 to 10. See how you can do it using a for loop. Is that clear, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Any queries? Any queries, ma'am?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay. One or two questions, I'll just put it. Range takes how many arguments?
Three.
Good. How many, what types of arguments it takes?
Integer.
Okay, very good. Suppose if range takes one argument, so it will be treated as what argument?
Stop
argument. Okay. By default, in that case, start is what?
Zero.
Yes, zero. Very good. Step value?
One.
Okay, very good. Suppose if I give floating numbers in my range as an argument, what do I get?
Type error.
Okay. Can step be given zero?
No.
No, ma'am.
No. No. Sure?
Yes, ma'am.
Can arguments be negative?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What is the other name for for loop?
Definite.
Why it is called definite?
Because we know that how many times
the times it will be executed. Okay. Any other doubts you have as of now?
No, no.
Execute no, those programs. I will upload PPT shortly after. Maybe in the evening I'll just upload. Okay. You can just look into it. Mm-hmm. Any queries you can ask. Sharanya TS. She's not there. Sharanya.